earn first position means when you work hard in your exams, what you get in that.
We get good marks and success.
When they announce your name, they say Elsa got or get first position. Okay, and first place means got first position. A well-rounded student. It is also very easy. A well-rounded student means such a student who performs very well in every field, okay? Or you can say in different fields. Performing well in different fields. Number D, along with a group of other students means it means working together. Write on your book, okay? Working together. To look forward to it. To wait for something anxiously. To wait for something anxiously. Okay, last one, made it this far. It means got success. It means got success. Now look at page number 8. C is translation, related to translation. Translate paragraph 1 of the lesson into Urdu. You have to do it by your own. Okay, when I listen your lesson, you have to tell me. Now next is choose the correct option. The last couple of years have been a long bumpy ride for me, as they have for everyone of my age. The underlined phrase means easy time, B, hard and challenging time, C, leisure time. Which one is correct? I will ask. Fatma, beta, can you tell me which one is correct?
Option B.
Yes, option B, hard and challenging time. Good. The author thinks he will become a well-rounded student by making good grades in academics, participating in co-curricular activities, or partaking both in academic and co-curricular activities. Yes, Ilsa?
Option C, partaking both in academic and co-curricular activities.
Very good. C option is correct, partaking both in academic and co-curricular activities. Now look at page number 84. Number 3 statement is, his summer jobs in the preceding 2 years helped him gain an understanding of independence and responsibility. B, get financial boost. C, make friendships. Yes, Fatima?
Option A, gain an understanding of independence and responsibility.
Very good. A option is correct. Gain an understanding of independence and responsibility. Number 4, the author has become more dashed because of his job experience. Well-to-do and prosperous, mature and responsible, social and well-known. Which one is correct, Ilsa?
Option B, mature and responsible.
Very good. B option is correct, mature and responsible. Number five, this developing positive outlook has given the author the motivation he needs to become famous, wealthy, or successful. Fatima.
Option C, successful.
Option C, successful. Very good. Answer the following questions. We had done all these questions. Now look at page number 85. Indefinite pronouns. Underline indefinite pronouns in the following sentences. Example, they have given you examples. Indefinite pronouns means such pronouns which are not known. You can say unknown pronouns, okay? Regarding their strength, their number. The last couple of years have been a long bumpy ride for me, as they have for everyone of my age. The bold letters everyone is indefinite pronoun. Now you have to underline them, okay? First one is, Elsa, please read this statement first.
Everybody enjoys a good movie.
And also tell them which one is indefinite pronoun.
The word everyone is an indefinite pronoun.
Very good. Everyone, underline everyone. It is indefinite. Read next two.
Does anyone have the time? The word anybody is the indefinite pronoun.
Very good. Anybody is indefinite pronoun. Underline it. Next one also.
One sang while the other played the guitar. The word one is indefinite pronoun.
Which one?
One
or other?
Other.
Yes. Other word is indefinite pronoun. Please underline it. Read next one.
Nobody knows the trouble I have seen. The word nobody is indefinite pronoun.
Very good. Word nobody is indefinite pronoun. Underline it. Also read next.
The secret was known by few. The word few is indefinite pronoun.
Very good. Few is indefinite pronoun. Underline it. Now, Fatma, please you start reading from statement six.
No, the secret was known by many. Many is indefinite pronoun.
Very good. Many is indefinite pronoun. Number seven also.
Mathematics is too hard for some. Some is indefinite pronoun.
Some is indefinite pronoun. Very good. Next one.
Surely you recognize somebody. Somebody is indefinite pronoun.
Good. Somebody is indefinite pronoun. Last one.
Is there anything that I can do? Anything is indefinite pronoun.
Very good. Anything is indefinite pronoun. Underline it. Now look at exercise B. Tick the verb which agrees with the indefinite pronoun. You have already know about have or has, so you will feel easy to choose both of one, okay? Each of the following family members has have one vote. Elsa.
Has.
Each. According to each, we will choose has. Good. Second one, one of the boys eat or eats pizza every week.
Eats.
Eat one of the boys. We will focus on one.
We will focus on eats.
Eats. One of the boys eats pizza every week. Okay, next one. Fatma, you tell me. Both of the answers is or are correct?
Both of the answers are correct.
Very good. Both of the answers are correct. Number four, Fatma, again tell me. A few of the staff was or were gone today.
A few of the staff were gone today.
Very good. Were gone today. Next, also number five, all of the animals run or runs when they are scared.
All of the animals run when they are scared.
Run. Good. Elsa, now tell me, someone has or have his own thoughts.
Someone has his own thoughts.
Very good. Has his own thoughts. Fatma, you tell me, you know that others has or have tried this.
You know that others have tried this.
Have tried this. Very good. Now open next page. Present perfect tense. You know very well about present perfect tense. Its helping verbs are has or have. Her form is used in this tense. Okay. Now you have to complete these blanks according to this tense. How long dash he live in Karachi? Elsa.
How long he has lived in Karachi?
How long has he lived in Karachi? Has. Okay, good. Fatma. Second, I dash speak Chinese for 20 years.
I have speak Chinese for 20 years.
But you have to use third form. What is the third form of speak?
Speak.
Second is spoke. Third is?
Spoken. Spoken.
Yes. Yes, yes. Good. I have spoken Chinese for 20 years. Now, Elsa, you tell me. Dash, Alia fly in an airplane before?
Has Alia flown in an airplane before?
Very good. Has Alia flown in an airplane before? Now, Fatma, you tell me. Shan, dash, not go to lunch yet.
Shan has not gone to lunch yet.
Very good. Shan has not gone to lunch yet. Number five, Elsa. Our class dash take a field trip 3 times this year.
Our class has taken a field trip 3 times this year.
Very good. Has taken a field trip. Fatma, you tell me where dash they move to.
Where have they moved to?
Very good. Where have they moved to? Last one. Elsa, you tell me, Javeria dash asked that question 4 times today.
Javeria has asked that question 4 times today.
Javeria has asked that question 4 times today. Very good. Okay, 10th class we had has completed our exercise of unit 7. Now we will start our unit number 8, which is a poem. Its name is Peace. Peace means sukoon. Open page. Its translation is not compulsory. But we will do it only for understanding. Okay. The wind is now. Hawa ab hai. A roaring, smashing monster of destruction. Roaring means dhaadti hui. Jaise lion roaring karta hai na. Bilkul waise. Dhaadti hui. Kuchalti hui. Aur tabahi. फैलाने वाली एक बला. रैकिंग ऑल मैंस वर्क. रैक मीन्स तबाह करना. तमाम इंसानों के काम को तबाह करने वाली. from the valleys, from the vales. Valleys mean wadiyon se, vales mean sabzazaron se. And sends them spinning or inhe guma kar phenk dene wali. Broken, flying, toot kar udati hui, ya tod kar udati hui. But all of that is not its core. Lekin ye sab iske andar ki hakikat nahi hai. Core means hakikat bhi ho sakta hai, sachai bhi ho sakti hai. Its center is in truth. Iske andar sachai hai. Eternal stillness, hamesha rehne wali, hamesha rehne wala sukoot, ya sukoot ko hum khamoshi bhi keh sakte hain, ya sukoon bhi keh sakte hain. Bright blue skies, chamakdar nilbu asma, and all you hear or tum sab sunte ho are gentle whispers, iski halki si sargoshiyan, far away bahut dur se, and unimportant or ye gair ahem hai ya ye ahem nahi hai. Dr. Hartman. Okay class, this poem is about wind. It is a simple poem, but it also has the two meanings. One is its explicit meaning, which I read before you, and other is its implicit meaning. The poetess tried to explain you its two aspects, means wind's two aspects. One is destructive aspect of wind, and other is its kindness or peace aspect. In summary, which you have taught, when wind is in the form of storm, it smashes everything, it destroys everything, buildings, trees, fields, each and everything it destroys. But when it is very gentle and very, very cool, it gives also life. Because according to scientific point of view, water, food, and third one, air is very necessary for the life of any living thing. So when it is in cool or gentle form, it gives lives to birds, human beings, trees, each and everything. Okay. You have to learn its summary by heart. Okay, it is very important. Now we start its exercise. Look at page number 93. Here also you have to explain its meanings. Put out words from the poem which mean the same as the following. Extremely noisy. Can you guess which word relates to this word, extremely noisy?
Roaring.
Yes, good. Roaring. Right in front of this word, roaring. B, to be broken violently and noisily into pieces. Fatma, can you guess?
Smashing.
Good. Smashing. Right, smashing here. Number C, to make something level by using a rack. Elsa.
Racking.
Good. Racking. D, to make something turn rapidly round and round in a central point. Fatma.
Spinning.
Spinning. Good. Elsa, you tell me, lasting or existing forever?
Eternal.
Eternal. Good. Fatma, you tell me, to speak or say something quietly using only one's breath so that only the people closest to one can hear. Whisper. You often do it in your classroom. Ji, Fatma.
Whisper.
Yes. Whispers. Good. Give synonyms for each of the following words. Roaring, smashing, spinning, stillness, and core. Open your dictionary and find out its synonyms and write over these words, okay? Now look at which word in each pair below has the positive, more positive connotation to you. Circle your answer. I think you have read about connotation or denotation before this chapter. Can you give me any idea about connotation? What is a connotation? Okay, I tell you, I have told you before. First, I told you about denotation. What is denotation? Denotation, you can a dictionary meaning or explicit meaning. When you see something and explain it according to as a concrete noun, it is denotation. I have given you example of snake. When you saw a snake, you say it is a legless worm, you can say, or reptile, you can say. But when you explain its implicit meaning, the implicit meaning or inner meaning means connotation. Snake's implicit meanings means evil. Okay, so you have to explain positive connotation. Connotation also divided into two types, positive connotation or negative connotation. Positive connotation, when you read some word or it feels you very good according to its implicit meaning. Or negative connotation, when you read some word or it seems so bad or it feels to you bad. Connotation, you can also, it is emotionally attached to you, its words. I have given you a example of home. When you, a home has different words to explain, home, house, residence. When you you have to choose as a positive or negative connotation, when you use house, it is a negative connotation because it feels like just a building where nobody lives. It is just a building. But when you use, it is negative connotation. But when you use a home, you feel like a very friendly environment or loving or something cozy or like with a family. Okay, it is its positive connotation. Now, in this exercise, you have to choose its positive connotation. Students, do you understand or not? If you did not, you can ask me. Fatma, Ilsa, samajh mein aaya aapko?
Ji, miss.
Ki agar aap connotation ki baat karte hain sirf, ठीक है, आप किसी चीज का अंदर से जो मतलब निकालते हैं, ठीक है, उसको हम कोनोटेशन कहते हैं. वो वर्ड जो सा आपके इमोशंस के साथ भी अटैच कर सकता है. अब इसी को जब हम डिवाइड करते हैं, मतलब के इसको ग्रुप्स को इसके दो टाइप्स देखते हैं, तो पॉजिटिव और नेगेटिव कोनोटेशन होता है. पॉजिटिव ऐसा कोई वर्ड जिसको पढ़ के आपको बड़ा अच्छा सा फील होता है, और नेगेटिव वो जिसको पढ़ के आपको अच्छा फील नहीं होता. जैसे हम घर की बात करते हैं, एक घर, मकान की बात करते हैं और घर की बात करते हैं. मकान क्या है? मकान वर्ड हाउस बोलते हैं तो हमें लगता है जैसे कि कोई बिल्डिंग है, कोई बिल्डिंग, खाली सी बिल्डिंग, ठीक है. लेकिन जब हम घर की बात करते हैं, होम की, तो होम, तो आपने अक्सर घरों के बाहर देखा होगा होम स्वीट होम, मीन्स कि कोई ऐसी जगह जहाँ आपको बहुत मोहब्बत मिलती है, जहाँ आप फ्रेंडली रहते हैं, जहाँ आप को प्यार मिलता है, आप खुल के रह सकते हैं, ऐसी जगह को होम कहते हैं, ठीक है. तो वो उसका पॉजिटिव कॉनोटेशन होगा. अब आपने चूज करना है इसमें से पॉजिटिव कॉनोटेशन, ठीक है. फर्स्ट वन इज थ्रिफ्टी एंड इट्स अदर वर्ड इज पेनी पिंचिंग. एल्सा, कैन यू गेस?
थ्रिफ्टी,
यस, थ्रिफ्टी. अच्छा पुशी और एग्रेसिव, थ्रिफ्टी और पैनी पिंचिंग का पता चल गया। नहीं, जो कंजूस नहीं होते, पैसे बचा बचा के रखते हैं उसके लिए, पैनी पिंचिंग कुछ अजीब सा लगता है, थ्रिफ्टी जो है वो ठीक है। नाउ पुशी एंड एग्रेसिव, फातिमा कैन यू चूज पॉजिटिव कोनोटेशन?
एग्रेसिव।
विच वन?
एग्रेसिव।
गुड, एग्रेसिव। पॉलिटिशियन और स्टेट्समैन? हिल्सा।
स्टेट्समैन।
वेरी गुड, स्टेट्समैन। शेफ और कुक? फातिमा।
शेफ।
शेफ, गुड। सिलेंडर और स्किनी?
सिलेंडर।
सिलेंडर, ठीक है। डी एक्सरसाइज, चूज द अप्रोप्रिएट कॉनोटेशंस, विच वुड यू रादर बी कॉल्ड, थ्रिफ्टी और चीप? विच वर्ड यू विल, थ्रिफ्टी, गुड। विच इज मोर सीरियस, प्रॉब्लम और डिजास्टर?
डिजास्टर।
डिजास्टर, गुड। Elsa, which is more polite, sip a drink or gulp it?
Sip a drink.
Sip a drink, good. Next page. Fatma, you tell me, which would you be if you hadn't eaten for several days, hungry or starving?
Starving.
No. Hungry for several days. Starving means you don't have any source for getting food, but here you are only for few days are hungry. Okay, not for a long time. So hungry is connotative, positive. Which would you be after a walk in the mud, filthy or dirty?
Dirty.
Dirty, good. Okay, explain the following idioms and find out their Urdu equivalents. ये तो आपने उर्दू में मतलब इनको बताना है. It is no use crying over spilt milk. इसमें उर्दू वाला कौन सा है प्रोवर्ब इससे रिलेट करता है?
अब पछतावा क्या होगा जब चिड़िया चुग गई खेत.
जी, अब पछताया क्या होगा जब चिड़िया चुग गई खेत. Do not put off till tomorrow what you can do today. आत्मा,
आज का काम कभी कल पे ना छोड़ो.
जी, आज का काम कल पे ना छोड़ो. Out of the frying pan into the fire. हिंसा,
बता दे.
आसमान से गिरा खजूर में अटका, ठीक है. आउट ऑफ साइट, आउट ऑफ माइंड, ये कोई पहाड़ वाला है, ये बता सकती है फातिमा? साइट से आंख हो गया, आंख ओझल, पहाड़ ओझल. As you sow, so shall you reap. जैसा करोगे वैसा भरोगे. ठीक है. Now look at page number. Types of imagery. Okay. First two grammar, kinds of pronouns. They have given you all the types: demonstrative, reflexive, interrogative. Okay, you have to identify which one is demonstrative, which is reflexive or interrogative. Hand me that hammer. Elsa, can you tell me which?
The word that is demonstrative pronoun.
Yes, good. That is demonstrative pronoun. I saw myself in the mirror. Fatma?
Reflexive pronoun.
Myself is reflexive pronoun. Good. Who is there? Elsa?
Who is interrogative pronoun?
Yes, interrogative pronoun. He himself will be our new friend. Fatma, again.
Himself is reflexive pronoun.
Good. Is this your teacher's book? Elsa?
This is demonstrative pronoun.
Good. This word is demonstrative. Okay, which is your pen? Fatma?
Which is interrogative.
Good. Now next is present and past participles used as adjectives. They have given you examples. I was amused by the way she acted in the play. Acted is past participle, okay? Do you find this type of humor amusing? Amusing means present participle. Okay, now you have to choose appropriate participles in exercise B. Read it and complete also. Start from Elsa.
The movie was really interesting.
Really interesting. Good. Keep reading.
I thought it was a good lecture, but I wasn't very interested in the topic.
Interested in the topic. Fatma, now you read number two.
Our town is so boring that there is nothing to do here.
Yes, boring. So boring. Yes, also B.
Are you bored with the game already?
Are you bored? Now, Elsa, you start reading.
Have you heard her laugh? It's so annoying.
Yeah.
It's so annoying. Yes.
I'm really annoyed with one of my co-workers.
Really annoyed. Yes. Fatma, now you read.
The city was damaged during the storm.
City was damaged. Okay, next.
The information was quite damaging to his reputation.
Okay. Was quite damaging to his reputation. Elsa.
This treatment is really great. It makes me feel so relaxing.
So relaxed. Yes, next.
I didn't like that movie. I thought it was too depressing.
It was too?
Depressing.
Depressing. Too depressing. Very good. Now look at next page. Gerund phrase. In infinitive phrase or prepositional phrase. Phrase includes the gerund and the object of gerund or any modifier they have given you. Means bold letter word is in the following, the gerund is bold letter, written in bold letter, and gerund phrase is underlined. Increasing is gerund and the ours is its object. I have told you before, what is gerund?